Welcome to Tool Spec. Today I got the half inch drive impact wrench and mid torque. I get the high torque one. I want to see, is the different battery going to make a difference of how we can take those wheel nuts up the track?
We're going to test those four high performance batteries. First, we have our 4 amp hour HP battery, which uses cell model number 18650. Second, we have our 6 amp hour HP battery, which also uses cell number 18650. This one have more amp, so more power. Third, we have the new 4 amp hour Ryobi EDGE, which uses bigger cells, the 21700. It also uses the Tabless technology to give it even more power. The fourth one is the massive 12 amp hour HP battery, which is full of 21700 cells. This battery should have tons of power.
I just put those tires on. I just torqued all the wheel nuts to 500 foot-pound with this torque wrench. So we know that everything's starting at 500 foot-pound right on the dot. We're just going to back up those nuts. We're all going to use HP batteries for those tools here because they're using the HP tabs at the bottom of the tool to help them perform better. So
for this test, we're going to use the 33mm socket. There's an adapter here from 1/2 inch to 3/4. If you watch the Torque Spec channel, you're going to see that this just changed the percentage of the torque by about like 2 to 5%. I'll put the link in the description if you want to go see that video. So it won't affect your torque that much. Plus, we're comparing it with the same socket and the same gun anyway. We're going to start with the iTorque HP 1/2 inch drive wrench. I have that on automatic. Going to be the 6 amp hour battery. Now, if you know about those batteries here, 4 amp and the 6 amp, the mold that holds the cell together is not that good. And I broke a 6 amp hour battery before because it broke all the clip that hold the battery cell together. And then after that, the tab for the battery just snapped. Hopefully, they're saying that there's an upgrade for this one, for the head battery. For the 12 amp hour, so hopefully we don't break anything because this video is not sponsored. All right, 6 amp hour. Still works. All the batteries are fully charged. I just charged them before we started this test. We'll do this. Yeah, we'll do this one right now. See if it gives us more juice. And go. Seems similar, or maybe even a little bit faster than the 6 amp hour. Definitely more fast than the other. This is a 4 amp hour, so definitely way faster than this 4 amp hour. Now we're going to compare it with the 12 amp hour. And go. I guess it's on automatic. It gives more torque that you need, but it stops spinning when the wheel nut get loose. It didn't do it as much with the other one, but it was definitely faster to remove the nuts with this one. So now, I'm not sure if this mid torque can actually remove those, because as you can see, it was kind of hard to remove it with the high torque. Even though this is rated for 1,070 foot-pound of rake-up torque. This one is rated for 600. So we'll do one with the HP battery, the new EDGE one, the high-performance EDGE. We'll put this on the Hoto, just like the other gun. So one wheel nut with this battery, and we'll do the other wheel nut with the 12 amp, and we'll see if it can take it off. And go. Nothing's happening. It's not even trying to move it. Socket is getting warmer. The gun's not warm yet, but you're going to see about the 12 amp hour. That was giving us more torque with our high torque, half inch wrench. So hopefully we can remove one of those wheel nut with it. I've been trying this one, so we're just going to go to the one that we haven't touched yet. And go. Half inch driver and mid torque was able to do one wheel nut with the 12 amp hour battery. Our EDGE battery didn't really seem to make a difference if we could do it. Maybe we'll try it one more time. No, I don't see anything move. So 4 amp hour EDGE is not strong enough for the mid torque to take those wheel nuts off. This gives us a little idea of the difference in between the amp hour and how much stronger the battery could be. The 4 amp hour EDGE, I'm pretty sure it compares a lot to the 6 amp hour HP. But the cost difference is way more expensive to buy the EDGE one. So now we have to do some tests and see if it's true that it runs colder. We'll have to really push this battery, but that's going to be for another test. So right now you can see that the 12 amp hour is definitely what you need to do with the high torque impact to remove those tires. Those batteries are way too expensive. This runs about $200. This is about $300. If you're going to do this kind of work, I would stay with the hair tools. This is not worth it to put the life of those battery at risk because of all the vibration of those guns. Now, those guns are very good if you're going to do tie rod ends or other little jobs like this. Go ahead and buy the guns, use the batteries, get speed up instead of having to bring airline all over the place. But if you're going to do big tire and big jobs like this, if it's for a jam on the side of the road, yeah, go ahead and use this. But I would not risk those batteries doing this kind of work every day. Hope you like the video. Give me a thumbs up, subscribe, and join me for the next test for those batteries. We're going to keep pushing them and see if this actually runs colder than the other ones. See you in the next video.